is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice as we lift his name. This is the day that the Lord has made. Come and rejoice, we will rejoice and be glad in it. Whether the sun will shine, whether the skies will rain, I know that you are good, and this is the day you made. Whether in life or death, whether in joy or pain, I know this truth remains, that this is the day you made. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice as we lift his name. This is the day that
you come together, parents and friends, staff, all of us as a family of St. Francis Academy, Union City, to celebrate the special event for our parish. For the first time, some of our young people are going to receive the body and blood of Christ in a special meal called the First Holy Communion. Let us get ready to eat this meal by remembering that we sometimes do wrong things, things that hurt other people. Let us now tell our Heavenly Father how sorry we are for hurting each other and hurting God. The work of our redemption through the Eastern mystery of Christ, your Son. May we who faithfully proclaim his death and resurrection, the sacramental signs, and experience the constant growth of your salvation in our life.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Wisdom has built her house. She has set up her seven columns. She has dressed her meat, mixed her wine. Yes, she has spread her table. She has sent out her maidens. She calls from the heights out over the sea. Let whoever is simple turn and hear. To the one who lacks understanding, I say, come, eat of my food, and drink of the wine I have mixed. Forsake foolishness that you may live. Advance in the way of understanding, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorio Psalm. The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
He commanded the skies above, and the doors of heaven he opened. He rained manna upon them for food, and gave them heavenly bread.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
And he brought them to his holy land, to the mountains his right hand had won.
The Lord be with you. Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. My flesh is true food, and my blood is a true drink. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh, drinks my blood, remains in me and I in him. Just as the living Father has sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, unlike your ancestors who ate and still died. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord. Today, you all look so marvelous in your beautiful dresses and handsome suits. They look so very happy, smiling with your parents, friends, brothers, sisters. Your parents, teachers, relatives are all smiling with joy for you. After this celebration, we have a big party waiting for you. I am proud of each one of you as a student of this great institution of St. Francis Academy in Union City, New Jersey. I know some of you might be a little nervous, most of you are smiling, but I think that you are most excited about receiving Jesus, the Holy Communion. It is because Jesus said he would be there in the consecrated bread. Ever since his resurrection on Easter Sunday, Jesus has a glorified body for the life of our bodies. In the same way, spiritual food is essential for the life of our souls. And the food for our souls is the body and blood of Jesus. That's why Jesus said we would be spiritually dead if we don't eat his body or drink his blood. Hence, you have to receive Jesus, the Holy Communion, every time you participate in the Holy Mass. And you have to receive Jesus after asking his pardon and forgiveness for your sins with great mistakes and with great reverence, with respect and love for Jesus. The final question, what will you do after receiving Jesus, the Holy Communion? Finally, you must remember that you are carrying Jesus today to your home and schools as Jesus' mother Mary carried Jesus to her cousin Elizabeth.
This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice as we lift his name.
Dear Jesus, we ask your help for all our sisters and priests, that they will guard us as children so we may all go to heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Jesus, please take care of all the sick, hungry, and homeless people in the world. Help us to always share what we have with others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Jesus, please watch over our church families. Join them together today and every day as we take the next step as members in the sacrament of the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Pope, Pope Francis, for good health and guiding the church in holiness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dear Jesus, thank you for the gift of yourself. Help us to always remember that you died to save us from our sins. May we have the strength to give the gift of ourselves through our access to you daily. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our president and all the leaders of the world, that they will make decisions to bring peace to all lands. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Remember our troops, the men and women who are protecting us daily. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of our family, especially Gladys Vargas and Kimberly Vela, that they may rest in the peace of Christ. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear our prayer for these beautiful young people and their families gathered here to celebrate. May your Son Jesus come to them today more fully into their hearts, into their families. May His life in them bring peace, joy, and love to their homes. May they bring Your spirit of love to all those around them in their families. Amen. Please be seated. Now, as a Catholic tradition, we have the offertory, and also we have a little collection to help our church, to help the celebration. And this church, St. Francis Academy, parents, teachers, you're always helping our parish church to maintain it. This is your home, so thank you very much for your generosity and sacrifice. God bless you all. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time He was betrayed, He entered willingly into His passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass. And lead us not into temptation. In loving memory of this first communion of these young people, those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word. Give a great applause for our Blessed Virgin Mary for the dedication. Today is a very happy good news is that all the parents who are here to receive the Holy Communion with the young people. Give a great applause for these wonderful parents, Catholic parents. God bless you all. Father Fernando, myself, we are very happy to see the Catholic parents communing for communion. It's awesome. Please rise for the final prayer. May sharing at the heavenly table sanctify us, Lord, we pray, so that through the body and blood of Christ, the whole family of believers, especially these young people, may be bound together in peace, love, and joy through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Bring God's love to your homes. Have a blessed, wonderful day. Give a great applause for these young people for the first time. Please be seated. Please be seated. Now the principal comes, takes the podium to say a few words of appreciation, thanks for all of us. She's a wonderful principal, Catholic principal, helping all our young people, the parents.
Children, I want to speak to the children first. Thank you, Deacon. You did a wonderful job. That was the most wonderful first communion I have ever seen. You knew you were receiving the body of Christ. And when you came up even to pray to Mary, it was so beautiful. So beautiful. You'll never forget this day, just as Father said, for your whole life. And parents, I was looking at your faces, shining with love for your children. How beautiful. What a wonderful day this is. And the Catholic Church is alive and well in Union City. I never saw so many people come up for communion. I'm delighted. Give a round of applause for your moms and dads and your grandmas and your grandpas and your friends. They're so happy today. They have big smiles on their faces. I'm looking at them. There are a few people, though, that we need to thank today, and that's Father Nathan. He's so welcoming for us to come to St. Joseph's and Michael's. Thank you, Father Nathan. And it was beautiful. And our dear Deacon, thank you, Deacon,
Felix.
So much. Of course, Miss Hogan. I certainly rarely seen such a beautiful first communion, and with such singing, sang so beautifully. And of course, I always must thank Mr. C. So later, we're going to go celebrate and probably have a big party and have a lot of fun. You look so beautiful. And the next time, you could wear your first communion dress to Mass tomorrow, and then you'll wear your communion outfits again to crown the Blessed Mother. On May, I think it's 31st, correct, Ms. Hogan? We will be crowning the Blessed Mother, and that is very beautiful. So I want to thank everyone, thank the grandparents who traveled from Spain and Italy and all over the world. That's how important First Communion Day is. Thank you, parents. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Amen. Please rise for the final blessing. May Almighty God bless these parents and godparents, especially all these young people who receive the Lord Jesus for the first time. Through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, may God bless each and every one of you the coming days with health and happiness and joy. May our Blessed Mother pray for you. St. Francis of Assisi, our patron, help us for these young people to grow in the faith and love. Have a wonderful weekend. God bless you. Give you applause. Para Dios, para God. Amen. Thank you, Father.
See you.